So we are going. The idea of this presentation is to show SAO, the new web client for Tryton. And so the idea is that we will show you, me and Nicolas are going to perform the same operation in the demo, each one on each client. So you can, you will be able to see that you can do normally everything in both clients the same way, and that they work together the same way, almost. Let's start. But I don't know if... Does it work like that?
No.
Do we have to use the mic?
I can hold it for you.
I will need my most of my hand.
Yeah, I'll give you a hand.
Let's try like that.
Just move a little bit to your left.
Like that?
And you can talk.
Okay. So first, login. As you can see, it's almost the same login window. Let's go. So it's a new database, so we have the configuration wizard to run. So you can see the wizard run on both sides. Next. So first you have to create the companies. Here is the form for the company. So let's create a company. F3, did you press it?
What?
F2, F4.
I don't know why I didn't press F3.
I press F2. So we have the shortcut going. Create the company, the Mifflin. Okay. The currency, let's pick US dollar, because it's a dummy thing. So we have the completion on both sides.
Okay.
So escape is to close the window. So I will also escape. now we are done. But let's first create the default account, because now we can still recover for error from the visage. So in the financial corporation, in account configuration, you have the default accounts here that you can select.
Is there a way to toggle the menu in the web itself?
No. You can recycle it?
Yes. The web plane is responsive, so if your Windows is smaller, it will resize.
I will try to show you that.
And I saw it in the mobile, but I was asking in the...
It depends on the size. So when the size comes too close, it will hide the menu automatically.
Oh. I don't know if you can see there.
But maybe you can just resize the window, not use the...
No.
And you have the toggle menu buttons, which can toggle the menu over.
The toggle menu button there.
Okay. So you get the menu up here. And depending on the size, it will appear on half of the screen, if you have enough size, or on almost all the screen. So, yeah, we try to make it smart for users. So, and you can see also the two bars, it becomes a menu, and so on. Okay, so.
Alors.
So we can save. Now we are in the same state. So let's first start by creating some parties, customer and supplier parties. Everything was done to really try to look exactly the same, like that you don't have to check your views on both clients. If it works for one client, it must work for the other. That's all for that's enough for the customer. Do we have something to show? That's it. You have the new notification pop-up, or I don't know what to name it. Notification.
Hello.
now Tryton show you this kind of notification when something happens. You can close it like that. It creates the supplier party. You can see now also that the new design for required fields, the fields that are required are in bold, and the fields that you can edit are in italic. So I can edit this one, but this one it's not editable. I tried to type on it, and you can see the same on the web client. After the party, we can create some product. So, maybe product. We are going to sell goods because it's more funny with the sock. Unit, let's take unit. Price, $10, and the cost will be $3. We can sell it and purchase, so pull-out fields, standard. And you can see for example, the supplier tabs appear and disappear depending on the state. For the customer, we have nothing to say, or maybe you can put a delivery time of 2 days. And the supplier, we are going to define our supplier as the supplier of this product. Here, supplier. No need to put a name for this product. We put a delivery time for the supplier. It's 4 days. And of course, we could have put a price list, but we don't need to go too deep in it. And here, the accounting. Oh, maybe we can show something. Let's try to save it, even if we know that we cannot save it. So now we have this kind of error message. It's quite difficult to read. So the Tryton now tells you the fields that are required and missing, and put the focus on the field. The first field you have to fill, and special cases for the web client, he highlights also the field. So let's put the field, the missing part. And when you start to change, to edit your form, the notification is gone automatically. Okay, and now we can save. Okay. So, let's save it. Oh no, first we have to create a fiscal year. So we can go here, the configuration, fiscal year. Yeah. This. Yes, the date format depends on of your locales. So here's Nicolas, look at SAO, I don't know what. It's not English. So if you put correctly the date, it works in the right format. Let's create quickly some sequence on the post move. We are going to use the same sequence for all invoices. Still, the usability of the GTK client is faster.
Yes.
Okay. Let's save and we create a monthly period. So the buttons works the same on both sides. And here you have the one to many, and as you can see, the web client. We don't have a scroll bar. It's the whole page that is the scroll. So you can scroll. And when you start to scroll, the toolbar stay on top. Like that, you still have access to the toolbar and you can scroll. And if the one too many, there is too much records in the one too many, you will have a more buttons to fetch more values. I think the limit is 40. 80? No, on the web, I think it's less than. Okay, so now we can make a sale for the product. Let's say to our customer. So now, quick hint. You didn't create the manifest. Probably some bugs. and now a new stuff from 3.8 version. You can ship the sale to another party if you want, or you can leave it empty and it will be the standard customer who will be delivered. Let's put a sale date for a little longer. So. Let's say 18, because we don't have in stock, so we cannot sell it now. Let's create a payment term. We want the customer to pay us directly, so we create just one reminder line to pay us directly, and we are going to sell 10 our products for a quantity of, let's say, 10. And so here we know the delivery date, which is 2 days later, because we put that delivery date was today.
Where's my
Search for it, maybe.
Yes, yes, I made a search.
He said.
But.
Ah non, t'as pas créé, t'as pas de template. T'as pas de variant.
J'ai créé mon produit.
Ouais, t'as pas de variant.
Ah,
I think we have a bug with the default values of 1 to many.
Ah, yes.
You can double click. So you can see also in the web that the total amount are updated on the fly and the same way it is on the GTK client. Let's make a quotation. And now we can confirm. And process the sale. So now we have one invoice and one shipment waiting here. So we are going to let's ship the product to the customer. So customer shipment. So we have the times of the views that works most well. So our customer shipment is in waiting state. And now we can try to assign to use the workflow. And can see that the web browser, the web client also remember the state of the preview open, the menu open directly. Dibo effect. I don't know why you cannot assign because. aux autres. Sinon, tu assignes avec ton plus grand titre.
Ok.
So, there is partly a small bug in the access right on the buttons. So, Nicolas will assign the using the GTK client. That should not happen. The idea was to show that we can show a pop-up from the buttons. But of course, so we don't have enough products. So let's go back. We have to, of course, we have to fill, to fulfill our warehouse. So for that, we will just run the purchase request wizard. So it's a wizard that we can run from the menu. And it will look at the stock and create the new purchase request to fill our warehouse. And it didn't create any purchase request. Because
We didn't say that the product is supplying.
I think the dates are too far because we can we put a supply delay of 4 days, and indeed we can, and we have to deliver on 20, so we have enough time to not buy it now. So it's we will change here the delivery time and increase to 7 or 10. Make it enough time. And now we can run the purchase request wizard. And we have our purchase request. Okay, and now we are going to purchase less than what the system tell us, like that we can have the assignation, the backlog for the shipment created. So we are going here. The system tell us to buy at least 10. So we propose to buy 10, but we are going to buy only 5. Okay. So I will synchronize with Nicolas and create the purchase. So now we have the purchase waiting for us. Tryton automatically choose the right supplier, and now our supplier tells us that we cannot buy 10 but only 5. So we put 5. Okay, let's make the quote. Yes, so we have here the pop-ups windows for the validation, the pre-validation buttons. So we have also, like for the notification, nicely written message from Tryton that tell us that we missed at least one of these three fields. So we are, what we are missing is the payment term for the for this purchase. So here we are going to use the same payment term that, that we created. Oh, it's here, so we can now go to the code. Voilà, the transaction. So good. So you can see also that on the web client, we support search on the one-to-many here, and the state, because can you remove the supplier? For example, if we don't have yet the supplier field, the search is disabled. So that works the same way on both sides. And we can get the lines from the supplier. You don't have yet the auto-completion of the condition. Okay, and now we can receive the product. And put it in inventory. So now we can ship our customer, even in advance, because it was normally planned for later.
Can we try again in the...
Still? No. So... Here the glass has to be... Yeah. So, as expected, we cannot ship five products because we have only received five. The house. So, Tryton split the lines in two, and we are going to ignore this one. So, we just delete it. So, yeah, it's deleted. And you can see we have the same design where the deleted lines on one-to-many are just stroken, and you can undo the delete by selecting the line and click on undo. And now we can delete again and assign. Yeah, that's almost all the stuff. we can show, or we can go back to the save, which is still processing. The invoice is still waiting, the shipment is still waiting, of course. So, to show the relays, so we have the relays buttons, and we can go to the invoice, and let's post the invoice to the customer, like that. And here we have the post button. And the invoice is all redundant, as usual. So, yeah. We can print the invoice. So, reports are working. The difference is on the web client, we can only open it. We don't have the functionality to directly print to the printer because it's something the web stack doesn't have out of the box. So we can do it. So
in my case, it has downloaded the PDF.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And can
open the PDF. The OTT.
And
I can then open
LibreOffice.
So in the repo, if you have the print directly or something like that,
In the GTK?
No, in the web.
No, it will always open.
Always open. Yeah.
We've not yet find a way to ask for the web printing. Yeah. It's not part of the API of the web, so probably it's possible if we have some flash stuff, but I don't think we want to bother. So yeah. Len? So if for us it's all we wanted to show, but if someone has any questions on the web client or the new or even the new Tryton version.
Sí.
Okay. Bonsoir.